Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. So far, we have studied linear equations of the form y equals mx plus b. This form of the equation of a line is called the slope-intercept form. The slope-intercept form involves two constants, m and b. The numerical value of m is the slope of the line, and the value of b determines the point at which the line crosses the y-axis, called the y-intercept. The y-intercept is a point on the y-axis with coordinates 0, b. The slope-intercept form has the advantage of being simple, but is only useful when we know the exact point where the line crosses the y-axis. In some cases, when looking at the graph of a line, it may be impossible to determine the exact coordinates of the point where the line and the y-axis meet. However, we are often able to discover the coordinates of some other point on the line. There is another form of the equation for a line which we can use in this situation, called the Pointslope form. Using the Pointslope form, in addition to the line's slope, we only need to know the coordinates of one point somewhere on the line. The Pointslope form of the equation for a line can be derived by using the formula for slope which we learned in the previous chapter. You may recall that this formula uses the coordinates of any two points on a line to calculate the line's slope. If we call the coordinates of these two points x1, y1 and x2, y2, then the slope is the difference in the point's vertical positions y2 minus y1 divided by the difference in horizontal positions x2 minus x1. Now, let's say we have a line with a slope m, and a point on that line with coordinates x1 and y1. If we use any other point on the line as the second point in the slope formula, the calculated slope will always be equal to m. On the other hand, if we use a point which does not lie on the line, the calculated slope will not be equal to m. So only points which lie on the line will produce the correct values for m, and thus satisfy this formula. This line can therefore be thought of as a collection of all points with coordinates x and y which satisfy this equation. This equation is easier to read if we rearrange it so that the y's are on the left side and the x's are on the right. To do this, we multiply both sides of the equation by x minus x1. This allows us to cancel the denominator x minus x1 on the left side of the equation. The result is the point-slope form of the equation for a line. Let's try an example using this form to write the equation for a specific line. Let's say that we are given the graph of a line, but not its equation. We are told that the line has a slope of 3/5. Since we know the slope, we might try using the slope-intercept form to write the equation for this graph. We start by assigning the value of the slope, 3/5, to the constant m. But from looking at this graph, the exact point where the line crosses the y-axis is not obvious, so we don't have an exact value to assign to the constant b. But let's say that we know that the line passes through the point 4, 3. Since we know the slope and the coordinates of one point, we can write the equation for this line using the point-slope form. Since the slope is 3/5, we assign a value of 3/5 to the constant m. And since the coordinates of the known point are 4, 3, we set the value of x1 and y1 to 4 and 3. So the equation for this line in point-slope form is y minus 3 equals 3/5 times the quantity x minus 4. You may sometimes see the point-slope equation written with the variable y alone on the left side. To write the point-slope equation in this form, we simply add y1 to both sides, canceling out the negative y1 on the left, which gives us the point-slope form with y alone on the left side. Now let's try another example using this form. Once again, we are given the graph of a line but not its equation. And once again, it is not clear from looking at the graph exactly where the line crosses the y-axis. We are told that the line passes through the point negative 7, 3, and that the line's slope is negative 2/3. Using the point-slope form, we set the value of m to the slope, negative 2/3, and the value of x1 and y1 to the coordinates of the known point, negative 7 and 3. This equation can be simplified if instead of subtracting negative 7, we add positive 7. The equation for this line is now written in point-slope form. Since we now have an equation which describes this line, we can determine the graph's y-intercept. It is difficult to tell by looking at the graph exactly where the line intersects the y-axis. However, we do know that the x-coordinate of this point must be 0, since every point on the y-axis has an x-coordinate of 0. Therefore, if we set the value of x in our equation to 0, we can solve the equation to find the corresponding value of y for that point. Completing the arithmetic, we add 0 plus 7 to get 7 and multiply negative 2/3 times 7, which gives us negative 14/3. We can then write 3 as 9/3 and add negative 14/3 to 9/3 to get negative 5/3. So the point on the graph with an x-coordinate of 0 must have a y-coordinate of negative 5/3. The y-intercept is therefore 0, negative 5/3. Since we know the y-intercept, if we like, we can now write the equation for this line in slope-intercept form. We already know that the slope is negative 2/3, so we assign this value to the constant m. And since the y-intercept is 0, negative 5/3, we set the value of b to negative 5/3. So the equation for this line, written in slope-intercept form, is y equals negative 2/3 x minus 5/3. Both of these forms are equivalent ways to write the equation for the same line. We can prove this by converting the top equation to the bottom equation's form. We do this by distributing negative 2/3 to the two terms inside the parentheses. Instead of adding negative 2/3, we can simply subtract 2/3. We then eliminate the parentheses and multiply negative 2/3 times 7 to get negative 14/3. We can then write 3 as 9/3 and add negative 14/3 to 9/3 to get negative 5/3. This makes the forms of these two equations identical. So, although the point-slope and slope-intercept forms look different, once the proper constant values are assigned, the two equations express the same relation between x and y and are therefore equivalent. However, either form may be more convenient, depending upon the information we know about the line. In the next lecture, we will introduce an additional form of the equation for a line, known as the two-point form.